these weapons can also be used for positive things, for agricultural purposes. But the emphasis here is that they must be identified through effective monitoring and intelligence gathering, and then the people involved in this deal must also be arrested and dealt with in accordance with the law. And then I think if the communities are involved and there are incentives for them to be doing this work, I think we'll be able to make headway in terms of reducing the circulation of small arms in the country.
And just to go back a little bit, these ex-combatants, we are told, are actually bringing in these weapons and trading them for bicycles and all. I'm wondering what would make them want to come to Ghana to do this sort of trade, if I can call it like that.
Yeah, I do not have the fact that this is actually happening, because I don't have the statistics, but I think if this is a confirmed report, it's a source of concern, because, as you said, what would be the incentive? So there's a need for thorough investigation and analysis to be conducted, so we know what are the incentives that is driving such illegal activities, and then what are the networks that exist already within the country or even outside, and how all the stakeholders could now come together to develop strategies to prevent that from happening. But I think given that this is now reported in the media, and now we are talking about it, is already positive, because it heightens the alert, and I'm sure appropriate action will be taken to make sure that this is not at the board.
Okay, and whilst Ghana is doing all these plus the education and the suggestions you've given, should we also as a country ensure that particularly our neighboring countries that have just come out of war, have been in war before, we work with them as far as this issue is concerned, because the report indicates that these ex-combatants are supposedly coming in from some of our war ravaged countries or neighboring countries?
Absolutely, absolutely. That's a very important suggestion you are making, because you have to have joint border monitoring teams in collaboration with neighboring countries, so that the countries are also taking control of their own side of the border, and then they can also establish a monitoring patrol team along the corridors of the border and work with the community as informants. And I think if this collaboration is possible and enforced, it will go a long way in reducing small arms circulation.
Thank you very much, Alimu Diallo. He is the regional coordinator for the West African Network for Peace Building. He's been sharing with us some ideas on how to handle this situation. He says we should take it as an alert, the fact that these small arms are being supposedly being traded between some ex-combatants and some people in the north of our country. We understand that they are trading them for motorbikes. We do not know what the motivation exactly is, and we're not too sure of which of the neighboring war-torn countries these ex-combatants are coming from. But also he believes that once we also collaborate with our neighboring countries to enhance our cross-border patrols, it will go a long way to help us deal with this situation. But we take a quick break here on today's big story. We'll be back to look at some more issues. Welcome back to today's big story. Now let's look at another issue on our table tonight. The Ghana Chamber of Bulk Distribution Companies, or BDCs, say it will tomorrow file an action at the court seeking an injunction to stop the handing over of the management of tank farms of the bulk oil supply company, that's BOS, to TSL, a Ghanaian subsidiary of a Nigerian-owned company.
I cannot believe in our own proven people. Who will? I hereby call on all Ghanaians and the private sector representative bodies, LIPEF, AGI, Ghana Chamber of Commerce, Chamber of Mines, etc., to join us in this clarion call for true action in the pursuit of true local content.
Now, the BDC Chamber's action, which is the latest step in its campaign to prevent the management of Ghana's national petroleum stocks and highly sensitive strategic reserves from falling into unproven hands. According to the bulk oil distributors, the deal violates Ghana's local content laws. In their view, the deal was part of a grand scheme to have TSL and their trading partners control the Ghana and Sahelian oil trade.
TSL operates three terminals in Nigeria, combined capacity 55 million. This is nowhere comparable to the proven capacity of indigenous Ghanaian companies, which amounts to over 270 million liters combined. Every single one of the companies you visited today exceeds TSL's combined capacity in Nigeria. Every single one, even one, is more than the capacity that people run there. Why TSL? Why not even open the process and let us compete properly? Why will you use the taxpayers' money to facilitate and promote the business of a foreign-owned company? We want BOS to do well. As a matter of fact, BOS facilitates our business. And we are not opposed to the idea of wanting to outsource. We fiercely oppose any acts by state agencies to pass opportunities to foreign or foreign-owned companies when indigenous capacity exists.
Well, Senyo Hosi, who is the Chief Executive Officer of the Ghana Chamber of Bulk Distribution Companies, has joined me in the studio. Good evening, Senyo. Thanks for joining us. So, you are not against the BOS outsourcing?
I'm not at all.
So, what is your problem with them giving it to a Ghanaian subsidiary of a Nigerian company?
Well, it's very simple. Indigenous Ghanaian companies have the capacity to offer the same service and probably possibly better qualified. But there's one thing I need to correct. There's no local content law to govern our downstream sector. So it is
well,
wrong
reportage.
No, yeah. Well, we are actually here to even work on that. What you have local content for oil and gas is for the upstream sector. Mm-hmm. So this is actually in line. The discussion here is in line with the president's own call for us to put local content before every single government procurement process. Mm-hmm. We should give the Ghanaian a chance. I think when proven, when given the opportunity, we can prove that we are competent people. The president said that in his own speech, I mean, during the State of the Nation address and all. Mm-hmm. So it just shocks me a bit why, you know, you have the president speaking so well and then trying to, share his honest ideology on local content. And you have appointees doing the total reverse. Look, BOS is a fantastic facility. It is an important and strategic asset to this nation. Fantastic. If you're having problems, you are having losses, and you think the best thing to do is to transfer the losses, I don't think there's a problem with that. You want to outsource the management of the terminal. There's no problem with that. That's a management decision it can take. Mm-hmm. But what do you do? I called the president. We have to look for solutions within our own borders. Okay.
And could it be then that BOS had already explored that angle? They probably weren't satisfied with what they saw.
Can
so they
I
decided,
ask a question?
Okay, let's partner with these people.
Can I ask a question? How do you explore the angle where do you engage the people? You don't open up the process. What the way? How do you determine whether they explore that angle? We've been here. We've been the major reason why there have been no shortages in this country for a good number of years now, since 2006, when BDCs got into this industry. Mm. And today, look, we account for 98% of product supplies to the market. Out of government's own policy, we have invested over $180 million in competence and skill. So once there's an opportunity, what do? You get your own people in. How can a company whose combined capacity is what experience there is 55 million liters, compare with those we have here who exceed that? Some one is 110 million liters. That's twice as much. How can you say for a second, or even think for a second, that they explored that? It was never explored. As to why they would choose to go through a sole sourcing route to select TSL, no, I think it flies flat. It flies in the face of the president's own clarion call for local content. We can't speak poetry and act prose. When the president speaks in many jurisdictions, that's a policy directive for all appointees. You can't have appointees doing the reverse. Mm. We should believe in ourselves as Ghanaians. Look, bro, if we can't believe in ourselves, who will? Mm. Those who prove capacity, you choose not to believe in them. Who should? How will a nation grow when it doesn't believe in its own proven people? No way. This won't happen in Nigeria just for a second. Let me tell you, Aliko Dangote, he's Africa's richest man. Mm-hmm. How did he make it? Government supported him and pushed him to grow. Okay? You have the same thing with Wando and Sarah. Yes, all around here, huge, huge oil companies. Wando is talking about buying ConocoPhillips, and that's a major upstream company. How did it get there? Its government allowed its indigenous people to prosper. Why not us? 55 million liters. Let me ask you, 55 million liters. Today, they come and start managing bus terminal, 420 million liters. Tomorrow, what do you have on your CV?
That they can't manage it?
No. Look, the problems are bus, in my opinion, is not rocket science. It needs some investment and it needs some process control. So that's not rocket science. It's an investment opportunity that should be made available to the Ghanaians, to the Ghanaians who have proven capacity. As a matter of fact, even all these people are not even willing to start fighting each other. They're willing to come together. So amongst the industry, we're able to take a share in the investment opportunity, prosper the interest of BOST, and also prosper our regular trade. Trust me, this is just the beginning of one grand scheme to render this entire market to foreign-owned companies and also the Sahelian market.
But you see, I find it a bit difficult when you say it is a grand scheme to hand it over to another market whilst our own people are here, because you're still operating.
No, let me tell you, when you have a massive facility like BOST, it's the largest infrastructure here. Mm-hmm. Infrastructure is a competitive edge. Who's going to put in the stocks in there? Another foreign company that BOST is also engaging, instead of talking to us. Okay? Mm-hmm. When that company comes in, a foreign-owned company, who I know is definitely connected directly and indirectly to TSL, what happens? They have easy access. I'll show you. These are the words of the management of BOST. That one of the incentives for this trader to come into this market, to come and follow their schedule and plan, is that it will have access to West Africa's second largest market, as well as access to the Sahelian market. So easily, it is obvious that your infrastructure can give people a competitive advantage. Why not give it to your own people? Why do you want to look elsewhere? What is this thing about local content? How would the Ghanaian entrepreneur grow if government and its agencies will not promote that whole ideology or that whole, thinking of local content?
And
that's wrong.
Whether TSL manages it or a Ghanaian, at least you still have access to the market.
Of course, we have infrastructure, but that's an investment opportunity. When TSL is coming in to manage that, do you think they are doing this for philanthropic reasons? They are doing it because it's an investment opportunity. Why do you want to give the investment opportunity to a foreign-owned company when you can give the investment opportunity to your own people? Why should we use our taxpayers' money to facilitate and promote the business interests of a foreign-owned company? It doesn't matter whether it can be done or not. Can your people do it? Yes, they can. So why not?
Well, we've actually been trying to get to government to speak to this particular issue, but unfortunately we've not been successful. My producer is still trying. Hopefully we'll be able to get through to government representation. But let's touch a bit on the legal side. You're going to court, you're filing an action tomorrow.
Of course, tomorrow morning, first thing in the morning, we've instructed our lawyers, Access Legal, to proceed with that.
And what are you hoping to achieve?
There are two things here. One, TSL, contrary to the requirements of the laws of this country, if you look, take the MPA Act, I think Act 691, anybody to operate here is supposed to be licensed by the MPA. They are not licensed to undertake or manage or operate a storage facility. It means it's an illegitimate transaction.
They're in the process.
You can't be in the process and start taking control. They are not in the process. But either they are process or not, it's immaterial. The law doesn't talk about whether you should be in the process or not. It talks about you having been licensed to operate. Okay. You've not been licensed by the MPA to operate. And you come onto our shores and try to breach our laws, with impunity. And this is being facilitated by Ghanaian appointees who are funded and paid for by you and me, our taxes. How can you work against your own people? Do we want to mortgage this industry out to foreigners? Let me give you some little history. The indigenous guys, 30 seconds. Look, we started as kerosene resellers. This industry used to be controlled by Total, Shell, Agip, British Petroleum, and all. Mm-hmm. Look at how far we have come. We've become oil marketing companies. We've become bulk distribution companies. Now we own infrastructure of this magnitude. Aren't we proud as a people that our own people are doing well and holding on to the prospects in this industry for the nation? The upstream industry, technology and investment keeps us way away. The downstream, we have money to close the gap, allow us to prosper.
So you're hoping at the end of the day, with this court action, that they would terminate the contract?
Well, we are seeking an injunction, the execution or the execution of the contract.
Okay.
And as well as also looking at the potential breaches that were done during the procurement process, because it's a public lab, a public owned company. It's owned by the state, 100% by the state. So it's supposed to be subject to that.
All right.
We should do the right thing on our own soil.
Okay. Thank you very much. Senyo Hosi is the Chief Executive Officer of the Ghana Chamber of Bulk Distribution Companies, and he's been explaining their beef, if I can put it that way, with BOST for getting TSL on board to take over its management of its tank farm in the Tema area. But stay with us. We'll be back shortly with the interactive segment. Welcome back, and now it's time for us to go to the other arm of this program, the interactive segment. And Marion Toure is in the studio with me. Hello, Marion.
Me?
Yes.
I actually thought I had a bad voice. What did you eat last night, the frog?
I don't know. Oh, I don't even know what I ate.
Sorry.
I didn't really eat anything. Really? I had a terrible headache last night, so I didn't even eat.
You sound terrible.
Oh, really?
If I was any better, I would have nursed you.
So what are you looking at?
I wanted to ask you how you're doing with your meter at home.
Which of them?
Meter, electricity.
Well, our relationship is kind of okay.
It's kind of okay.
Yeah.
So your meter is good to you?
Yeah.
And you're good
somewhat.
To it? Somewhat.
Yeah. Me, I'm good to it, but it is somewhat good to me.
Well, that's what I'm talking about today. Welcome to JN Interactive. My name is Marion Toure.
The first we talked about is the automated meter reading, where we are able to install meters which we can communicate with from our offices, so that whatever are the levels of consumption of our customers at their premises, at their industries, or their hotels, we are able to sit in our offices and know their level of consumption. It helps us in so many ways, and one of the ways that helps us is that it makes us detect any dysfunctioning of the meter or any tampering of the meter. So we don't need to even go to the field before we can unearth some of the abnormalities or the illegalities that customers may be doing or our meters may be dysfunctioning. We can sit at our offices and monitor them. Then we are also thinking about what we call common metering platform, where we have all our metering systems integrated in such a manner that when it comes to bending, a customer can bend at any point of our operational area, or when it comes to any system that we have in place, they will be common to every type of meter that we have been employed on our network.
So the gentleman you've just been hearing from is William Hatton Mensah, and he is the managing director of ECG, and he is saying that ECG is replacing the new metering system, and that they now know that they are the poles that are outside of your homes would not, they're not efficient now, so now they're going to replace them. If you're just joining us, this is JN Interactive within today's big story. I'd like to announce all the social media tools that you need to get in touch with the show. You'll find us on facebook.com/joinusontv. Join the conversation. We have all the posts there. You can comment on them and would amplify your voice by sharing it with the rest of the world. You'll find us on Twitter, joinus. On TV, that is our Twitter handle, and we also have a new Twitter handle for JN Interactive, and it's JN Interactive GH. You can also send your tweets there. We would amplify your voice with the rest of the world. If you're sending us an email, be joinusim@multitvworld.com. Our WhatsApp number has changed. It's 0540019009. So you can send all your WhatsApps there, and we will share them with the rest of the world. And JN Interactive is where tech meets news. to set the agenda. If you're just joining the discussion, I'd like to let you know that Electricity Company of Ghana is replacing the existing prepaid meters with another stock. It says will be more effective, and the exercise is expected, to roll out nationwide. We are actually talking about it, and we are asking what has been your experience with the existing prepaid meters, and what are, your expectations with the new ones? Do you even need them at all? So, the managing director of the company has also been speaking, and he says as part of new measures, it is taking steps to address system losses and improve network, especially around Teshi and Botiano areas. Let's take a listen to this next video blog.
In areas like Teshi, Botiano, we are embarking on what we call system loss reduction and network improvement projects. And basically what we are doing in these areas are that we have replaced the meters there with prepayment meters and have installed them on poles. We also have re-engineered the networks there, and we have injected a lot more transformers in those areas, so the areas have transformers that are loaded to about 70%. We have not loaded them the maximum capacity, so that we're giving some room for whatever expansion or further development that will happen in those areas. We have also improved upon the voltage levels in those areas for the customers, and we have increased revenue in those areas, and our parameters also indicate that we have also reduced losses in those areas.
So if you're actually wondering what all these initiatives by ECG are all about, the managing director says ECG is very eager to meet the 2014 benchmark set by the PURC and ultimately improve their quality of service to you. Let's take a listen.
For us as a utility distribution company, our business is to purchase electricity and sell. And we need to account for whatever electricity that we have purchased and we are selling. And there are challenges that we have with system losses. We've been able to work hard on them, and they used to be as high as 27%, but they are around 24% within a very short period of 2 years. But we want to try and get to the benchmark of PURC, which is 21%. And we need to embark on these projects that are needed to be able to get to those loss levels. That's what we are doing now. The first is to reduce the loss levels, and the second is to improve upon our revenue, so that the more we get our customers billed accurately, the more money we can get, especially through the prepayment system. Then out of that too, we want to also deliver quality service to our customers. So we are doing a lot of projects on the networks to improve upon the voltages, to improve upon the other services that we have to render to the customers. So we have a three-pronged approach that we are using for the business in order to make sure that at the end of it, our customer will have a better quality of service.
So we are actually asking, what are your thoughts on that? And if you actually like the meter that you're using right now, we've been out on the streets. Let's take our next video blog.
For me, they're prepaid, I don't like it. Because at the end of the month, I buy 70 Ghana. A taxi driver, how much am I earning from here? And I buy prepaid 70 Ghana. And if they give light off self-crap, the meter is ready. So prepaid there, for me, Mr. there.
I think the new prepaid meters in the system is not good at all, because it has been giving a problem. When you buy credit to put it on it, it doesn't last to take you like a week, then the credit has finished about it. So I think the old ones are good, so you should still use the old one.
The prepaid meters we have in the system now is a failure, and then we can't entrust another one in advance, because due to the one we are experiencing for now, hasn't been anything good. Just a failure to us.
No, I don't think it can help us. So for me, we don't need it. They shouldn't even introduce it. We don't need it at all. The one that they have given us, the prepaid card, we call it bomb. It explodes. It don't work. We don't need it. So please, for me, if the government will listen to me, they shouldn't even bring it at all. We don't need prepaid meter. I think you heard someone is making noise over there. Almost 95% of Ghanaians are complaining. Those who experience the prepaid, we are complaining. It's too much. And now in the system, there is no money. All right? So tell me, where are we going to get the money, right, to fix these prepaid meters? It will not help us, please.
The prepaid, I hope that is very teaching. It's very bad. But for us, for the old, for old meter, that one is not going fast, or is, there's no any bad or good this thing in it, but it's very good than the prepaid.
So you have him complaining there. The old meter is very cheating. I believe he wants to say that you know, when he puts his credit in there, the credit just runs fast, so it's actually cheating him of his money. Yeah, I really get you, my brother. I am with you on that one. Let's take some comments that have been dropping in on Facebook before we go and take some more blogs, and then our WhatsApp for the day. Precursor is already set, and we've been asking you to share your experiences with us. You know, today we are asking whether, you know, you like your old prepaid meter or you want something new. Philomeno Joe says, these ECG people are not serious, just wasting our monies. What have happened again to the old prepaid meters? We actually do not know. Anamfo says, they are gambling with our lives when it comes to electricity supply. When are the consumers going to have a say in whatever concerns us in this country? Are we consulted, by the way? No. John Paul says, I think they are confused. Some of these things need to be carefully checked before bringing on board. Some bad nuts will take this opportunity to do dubious connections and illegal connections. Benjamin says ECG must rather improve its service to us. Dumso must be tackled first before taking the metering policy from what? Organa. Okay, you are for sending this from Sunyani. Okay, Seth says creating another venture for Chop Chop. Leave them, they are just not serious. Yeah, Brewong. Abdul Razak, they should do more to stop the dumso that we're experiencing currently. What meter again? Are they confused? Home, that is Ghana for you. No wonder. Eric, another way to steal our money. Ras, what is the motive behind this? With this economic hardship going to be free? Is it going to be free? I hope and pray it should not affect us much as consumers. Daniel Pascal, they should rather think of better services to consumers rather than this project. Issa says, if only the new prepaid meters can check illegal connections, they are welcome. This is because illegal connections are too much if few people buy the credit. Katachia says, first, I'll be happy if they can tell us how much money or energy will be saved should we agree to this new expenses. They should let us know the cost-benefit analysis, and we want it documented for possible reference. Thanks. Kudas says the government must solve the dumso problem before talking about prepaid meters. If we have effective meters but the dumso still exists, then what will be the function of the meters? Or will the meters serve the purpose that they were made for? Atanga says, bogus decision. Kletus, it's a ploy. These new meters will run like Usain Bolt. Ben, they should use their homes for the test. Okay, and then when they will come and tell us, and we'll also join. That's not a bad idea at all. Adam says, the prepaid meters was not nationwide. How are we sure this will be nationwide? Frustration is what they are suffering. I'm not getting it. I'm not getting this one. Let's move on from this. This is what I call the incompetency in the highest order. They must take us serious in this country. Are they using us for try and error? And that's coming from Prosper. Ali Al Hassan, they should rather improve their service first. We are fed up with them, with their dumso. Baba Musa Tamale, I only hope this meter will be effective as they suggest. It is an admission by the ECG that the current meters in place are of poor quality. The activities of ECG and GridCo is impacting negatively on citizenry of this country, and which in the long run will create problems for the ruling party. I'll break off here and I will take our next video blog. And in our next video blog, we are actually asking you whether you are for, you know, the introduction of these new meters. Let's take a listen.
It's like an investment. I have to pay and buy the thing without electricity using, whilst my money that I used to buy can be used for something else. So I think we prefer the old meter. If the light is off, our money is freezed. If they are giving us light, we are paying in advance.
We want the old meter. We want the old meter. This people did there. For me, Mr. Did there.
And if that one is going to help us, yeah, I don't have a problem with it. Because I don't think if it will come and give us problem like the way the new ones are giving us right now. If they will bring another new one which will come and help us, I think that will be okay with that. So if they know that it will not help us, it shouldn't bring it into the system, because we don't want anything will come and help us or you come and destroy our homes and this thing. So if they know it's not good, they shouldn't bring it at all, so that we use our old meters, because I think the old meters are good.
We don't need it at all. The same thing they came to tell us, that this prepaid that they are bringing us, that one is better than the black box one. Then we were happy, jubilated. Hey, not knowing that one is a bomb, like I already said. So we don't need any new introduction. They should give us the old box one. That one is normal. We need that one. I think that one, we can live with it, all right. Because that was the meter our grandfathers were using. It has no problem. But now this prepaid meter, no, we don't need it, no.
But that one, even that one, I hope that I'm not feeling well. I'm not feeling about that. We want the old one, the old meter. But this meter, this prepaid meter, is not good. As for this prepaid meter, when the first time that I've started using the prepaid, when I buy 10 CD, I can use it like 2 weeks. When I buy 20 Ghana CD, I use it like 1 week. So this prepaid is very bad. Then the old meter, that one, I hope that the old meter is very nice for me. Yeah, as for me, actually, I want the old meter. But this old new meter, I don't want it like that.
I can share in this man's frustration. He just goes, I mean, a man is tired. Charlie, Ghana, you go BY. Let's hold on. I'm sure things will work out very well for us in the near future. Let's take some more comments that I've been dropping in on Facebook. Michael says, another meter, unbelievable. Would that help to stop the doomsaw? Instead of looking for new ways to generate more energy, ECG is embarking on another unproductive project. God help us. Donko says, I hope they don't change thrice. Okay, that's what you're saying. Antonio says, this is a new way ECG wants to cheat Ghanaians. Oh, wow. Belinda says, it's the worst I've ever experienced. ECG. Stephanie says, we should be prepaid for a new package. I'm not getting this one. Nate says, you're asking a question. I'm not getting it. Date says, why are they acting like a pendulum? They should think of improving quality service and stop replacing meters. Emmanuel says, cheer, visionless leaders. Christian Bliss says, is the new meter coming to solve the current doomsaw problem? Our gadgets are getting damaged by this electricity power challenge. And I can kind of see a thread forming here that you're all hoping for the doomsaw to end. So what you're looking for is something that is going to stop this doomsaw from happening. And so you're not actually in agreement of getting new meters. But all you want is for government to solve the problem of, this power situation that we have in Ghana. So we're hoping that if the authorities are listening, they should fix, you know, our electricity challenges and stop playing with the meters. They won't do anything. Daniel says, another what? Chia, what is even wrong with these people? This is what I call corruption. Osei says, cheaters of Ghana, both ECG and the policymakers. Wow. I can see some harsh words there. Agbenu says, stop deceiving Ghanaians. So, Everglow. I don't know whether that's an every word or not. Steven says, nothing about ECG is ever good. Watch men who claim they are engineers. Aziz, they should try and improve their services and stop the doomsor, which is actually making the government unpopular. Issa says, this is something that Ghanaians would not like because of its efficiency and the way it will be able to check illegal connections. William Benjamin Peters, hey, Ghana, this is somebody's personal contract, so they want to wipe the old ones again. How much is involved in the exercise and how secure are these new ones from the old ones? God will judge us all. Indeed, he will. Osmanu says, hey, we die finish. Ways and means to claim and take advantage of people. They should rather give us a better service. Is this better service? Ghana. Nuruddin, they should fix the doomsor and stop wasting money and in purchasing meters all the time. Will the new meters fix the doomsor problem we face? As for the meters they are to replace, they were cheating customers with them. Okay, so hopefully these new meters will not be cheating us, and we might have something great to say about the meters once they're in. Alhaji says, they just want to cheat customers with those meters. They run like Bolt very fast. When are they going to stuff their meters, their meter readers? Grammar, poor. Owusu says, coming events cast their shadows. This is a sign of failure and problems to come. They should set up and perform better. Majida, I will be sending this in from Gushigu. In fact, Marian, the existing ones have been terrible. Maybe this one will be better. But all these, for me, I think is due to ineffectiveness on their part. Trisha says, I will sack them when they get to my house. Check. Like, seriously? Oh, engineers are coming to work. Whether you like it or not, they will change it. This is Ghana for you. So even if you throw them out, they'll come back another time. And they'll come and fix it. Hussein Adams, ECG inefficiency at its best, just ripping off Ghanaians. Nana Kofi says they are just useless as they ignore the existing problems to infuse new ones. The company should be sold. And Abuga says, Ghana, is it that old ones are of poor quality? Or consumes current. You mean it actually takes a lot of your units when you buy it. And that is where we drop it for today. I am afraid we are out of time, so we can't take your WhatsApps that have been coming in, but some of you have also shared your comments on Facebook anyway, so we have killed two birds with one stone. Nia Kofis Matabe is standing by so we can wrap up together. Welcome back.
Did you say two birds?
Two stones.
No, I thought I had two bells with one stone.
Two beds with one stone.
Oh, okay.
What bells?
Oh, okay. No, that was what I had. So. All right, so Jane Exclusive comes up shortly at the top of the hour. That's it for the show. My name is Nia Kofi Smatabe.
Yes, and my name is Marian Toure. Enjoy the rest of our programs. Have a good evening.